Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. In the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most compassionate, the most merciful, all praise and thanks are due to him, and peace and blessings be upon his beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Subhanallah, under the main title, Alhamdulillah ala ni'mat al-Islam. Today, it happened with me that Allah made me witnessing or literally listening to two incidents through the radio. In the two incidents, two ladies, both of them, they were talking about someone who passed away. The first one, she was talking about her grandmother. The other one, she's a TV correspondent talking about a remarkable person who passed away. So both of them, they were holding very powerful, deep emotions to the deceased. However, I was touched by the fact that both of them, even though they love very much than the one whom they lost, but they did not mention not even one single word of anything has to do with his final destination. You know, in our culture, which is derived from Islam, by default, without even thinking, we say Rahimahullah, for example. May Allah descend his mercy upon him. Without even thinking, even the non-religious of us, by default, we say, Allahumma ahsan nuzulahu. May Allah grant him the best accommodation. Oh Allah, forgive him. Without even thinking, by default, immediately, because we believe in the hereafter, we believe what will happen, we have an idea what will happen. So we have this. To be honest with you, I was touched the time as if it was frozen in my face. I said, Subhanallah, what things, I felt in sympathy for them, because they don't know. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِنْ أَحَدٌ مِّنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ اسْتَجَارَكَ فَأَجِرْهُ حَتَّى يَسْمَعَ كَلَامَ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ أَبْلِغْهُ مَأْمَنَهُ ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّهُمْ قَوْمٌ La ya'lamun. If they, anyone from non-believers, on the time of war, can you imagine? If they ask your protection, your guardian, give them the peace, talk with them, tell them about Islam, then take them to a safe place that they can protect themselves because they don't know. I was asking myself, why did not actually one of them, she was talking about her mother, that they burned her, and she was talking about to handle the ashes. Ya Allah, my grandmother, I burned her, talk about the ashes, not mentioning a single word about the final destination. Now, the maybe they are religious, but maybe, they feel shy to speak in a public media about their religious beliefs, which is in itself, it's a problem. I'm afraid to express my religious belief in case, or they don't believe in anything. In both cases, really, I ask Allah to guide them. But my point is, I want to highlight, have we noticed the ni'mah that we are living in? Can you imagine how faith, which I'm not talking about philosophical faith, I'm talking about a real faith. The fact that you believe that there is a hereafter. You know the one who passed away, and Allah called it, Allah named it, أَوْ أَصَابَتْكُمْ مُصِيبَةُ الْمَوْتِ. Allah called it musiba. It's a disaster, it's a catastrophe for us. Yet, we know that it's just a matter of time and death is a gate for the hereafter. And at any moment, I might pass away. And if I'm, inshallah, you, we, he, she, from the people of the Jannah, we will meet together. So it's not the end. It's not an ambiguous ghamad. It's not an ambiguous status. We know why, when, how. In al-rajula, idha kana hadith al-Bukhari, إذا الرجل إذا كان في انقطاع من الدنيا وإقبال على الآخرة. The one when he passes away at the first moment of his being in his grave, قال يأتيه رجل صبيح الوجه, a man or a person, because for a man or a woman, a person will come with a very nice cheerful face. He will call man anta ya dhal wajh as-sabih. Who are you? You, those who have a beautiful face. قال أنا عملك الصالح سأبقى جليسك إلى يوم القيامة. I'm your right deeds. I will be with you till the day of judgment. قال ثم يمد له في قبره مد البصر ويقال له نومة العروس. You know, there's like, you know, wideness and extension in his grave. He will be asked to sleep. He will wake up at the day of judgment. We have an idea. We believe in that. Alhamdulillah. In addition to tens of times that we mentioned, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّ اللَّهُ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا تَتَنَزَّلْ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ. Allah is promising us that time when you pass away, if you have paid your tax, the religious tax, the divine tax, good deeds, آمَنُوا عَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, آمَنُوا عَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, آمَنُوا عَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. The simplest thing, you will be welcomed by the angels. تتنزل عليهم الملائكة. Angels will be descending by groups, just welcoming you. Can you imagine when thousands, if not hundreds of thousands of angels will be welcoming you when you move through the gate of death from dunya to akhirah? What kind of happiness you will be facing? The fact we know that will happen with us or with those who are dear to us. Have you noticed what kind of blessings we are living in? So from one angle, as I always say, let's from the bottom of our heart say Alhamdulillah ala ni'mat al-Islam. Secondly, please, let's do our best. Be part of our aim, goal in this life to let others taste the beauty of our faith. لأنهم قوم لا يعلمون. They don't know. It's our duty to let them know. Inshallah. Jazakum Allah khair. Assalamu alaikum.